Mandela also talked a lot about poverty, which is obviously an issue very close to your heart. I think he said, you know, without the eradication of poverty, there can be no true freedom.
Yeah, overcoming poverty is not the gesture of charity. It's an act of justice.
That's what he said.
Yes. And this, like slavery, like apartheid, he said, poverty is not natural. It is man-made, and so can be overcome by the actions of human beings. And he said, yeah, to some generations falls the chance to be great. You can be that great generation. I mean, I've been working for this man since I was a teenager, and he has turned my life upside down, or right side up, working on this struggle as a justice struggle.
And his leadership was in part his ability not only to get consensus, but also his ability to overcome the natural anger and bitterness and resentment he would have for being in prison for 27 years. He saw the need that he had to overcome that. He had to put that aside.
Yeah, he refused to hate, not just because he hadn't experienced rage, lived with rage, but that he thought, I think, that love would do a better job of liberation, of emancipation. Because, you know, what sort of country would they inherit if people were further embattled against each other? I mean, this is the gift of vision, I guess, into the future, being able to see a future before it exists. I mean, that's probably his gift, isn't it?
I mean, tonight, when you close your eyes, is there an image of Mandela that you have in your mind's eye, I mean, that you always kind of think of? I think of him being released from prison in 1990, leaving those prison gates with his arm up, Winnie Mandela by his side, that extraordinary moment when the world saw him for the first time. Is there, you know him personally, is there an image you have in your mind?
Open face, open mind, laughter, big, long, lot, laughter.